Good day, family and friends, and welcome back to the channel. Still with you is Phiwi Nhlanhlagama, and I'm so happy to be part of this journey with you. So today we're going to be having Solomon Zikalala with ours, and this is the first question that I'd like to ask him. He has been a PK all his life, so I'd like to really know what is that which motivated him to say, you know what, let me just continue on my father's footsteps, let me just preach as well. I just want to know what motivated you, what inspired you, what drives you to that end.
Hey, thank you very much, Phiwi. Thank you very much for having us here. I'm so much honored and so much grateful for this opportunity. Yes, I'm a PK. And I love it. What drove me into, you know, following the passion of my father, and you know, following him even in his footsteps. It's not just me liking it, but it's the will of God. It's my calling as well. God called me into this, and you know, I think I would say that my father has played a very huge part in sharpening my calling, because it was not just that I'm following him. I was just doing my will, but it happened that he was there as a man who's at the forefront for me. So for me, it was just accepting the will of the Lord, saying yes to his calling, and then just doing his will. And and I'm happy. I'm good. I'm content. I'm fine with it. It's actually a blessing for me that, you know, God calls me to ministry, and yet my father is also called. So it was just grace, and God worked it just by his own will and pleasure. Yes.
Now, as a child growing up as a pastor's kid, did you face any challenges in your PK journey, like not even quality time with your parents, and maybe all the finances going to the church, and you don't have enough money in the house like to spoil yourselves and whatnot? That as an example.
Challenges. There were challenges, but there were not really much, you know, because I think I early accepted this, and you know, well, even not really accepting, you know, God early made me know that even I myself, you know, I'm called. So when such things were happening, you know, it was really fine. In us not spending much time with our dad, there was not a problem for me, because you know, sometimes I'd even travel with him when he goes to preach, so that was not really a problem. What may have been the problem could be the finances, maybe, you know, finances that, you know, you as a PK, you need to think for the other people first before it's their family. But we were cool with it, but yeah, it was a challenge. It was a challenge, you know, because we had to support others, and then even at home we had to stay with people from outside. Sometimes find out that they are even more than us now, and we have to compromise here and there. So we were somehow, our lives were somehow compromised. We couldn't live as other young people were living. So yeah, that's it.
So you're married now. Well, congratulations. And I know dating can be a very tricky part when you begin, because you want to hide, or you want to keep your relationship as secret as possible. So how did you manage to hide it until the right time to even say, I'm getting married now, they can know my girlfriend? How did you manage to do that?
Thank you very much. Yeah. By the grace of the Lord, we now married. Thank you very much. How did I manage? How did I hide it? maybe that's a tricky one. But yeah, you know, love is clever. Yeah, love is clever. You know, love makes a way. So you know, we tried. You know, we would talk and you know, and agree as to when are we meeting, how. We tried by all means, But one of the things that helped is that we reported it very early to our parents. So we had that, you know, protection, nyana. But yeah, we had to run around and just be very, very clever in, you know, how we do it. And maybe let me say being wise, you know, and then being disciplined and using integrity in the relationship. But yeah, we tried and it happened, because when we finally stood up at church, people were like, wow, we didn't know this. And yeah, we're happy. Yeah, that's how we did it.
So do you think being a PK has impacted you positively or negatively, or do you think that it would put you anyway, even if you're not a PK?
You know, being a PK has really, really affected me positively, because, you know, for me, I took it in another way, in another perspective, because, you know, I felt and I thought it's grace, because, you know, what people got or rather get in church, I get straight in the house first, and you know, myself being a PK comes actually like before it actually resulted in me now being the GC, God's child, if I may say. Yeah, so it has really affected me positively, and a lot of things that I am today, it's because of my upbringing, of myself being a PK. And the question that says, would I be preaching if I went PK? Well, I'm not sure, because God knows, and maybe He saw it fit that for me to be effective in what He wants me to do, He would need me to be here, to be born in a pastor's family. So yeah, I'm not sure if I would preach, but I believe. I think I would preach, because, you know, this is my calling. It's who I am. So yeah, I think I would preach. Yeah.